And here on the Central Coast, the controversy over Arizona's new immigration law focused on what it might mean for the state of California, specifically the local agricultural industry. Salinas is a land rich in agriculture, the nation's salad bowl of the West. But there is something else growing in these fields, fear. Fear that Arizona's new tough immigration law could make its way to California.
It'll have a devastating impact on the ag industry there in the state of Arizona and throughout the United States.
Which is why hundreds of protesters came to El Salsal Middle School to raise their voices in opposition.
Immigrants come to this country to work hard, to do the jobs that nobody else wants to do, to harvest in the fields, to be janitors, to cook in kitchens, to clean the yards.
In Watsonville, protesters demonstrated at City Plaza for the annual immigration rights protest. This year, it took on a more urgent significance because of Arizona's immigration law. Demonstrators expressed their anger that police in Arizona will be allowed to stop people they merely suspect of being illegal immigrants and ask to see their papers. Critics say the law will lead to racial profiling and is unconstitutional.
Instead of feeling included, instead of feeling respected, there's a feeling of disrespect. There's a feeling of alienation. I think that a lot of people are scared. They're scared that their communities are going to follow suit, and we're here to protest all of that.
But not everyone thinks Arizona is off course.
I'm thanking Arizona for enforcing the laws.
California's become a nanny state.
Groups like the Minutemen and the participants of the Tea Party movement think Arizona is taking a step in the right direction. The one thing both groups agree on is that there needs to be some immigration reform, whether it comes from individual states or Washington, has yet to be seen.